We've been working on mobile microrobots probably 10 to 15 years here. We've been looking at how to control them, how to design them, how to make them. So these robots are very small, so you can't put a battery on them. So we use magnetic fields to control these robots. So as long as the robots have some kind of magnetic properties, we can control them using an external magnetic field. Now we're starting to work on some more advanced microrobot prototypes, and now for functions where they're not just static, rigid objects, can they actually deform and change and be active. We have now an adaptive tail, so we can change the swimming properties of the robot based on its environment to get it to swim more efficiently.
That's why we have the helical tails attached to the magnetic body. Helical tail is adaptive because we design with a modulating, alternating hydrogel regions from soft to hard. Under different environments, hydrogel is going to deform into a different shape.
So we have a way to adapt the shape of the robot. We can get more efficient swimming. Also, if we can change the shape, we could also change its geometry to go through small constricted areas that we couldn't get there if it was a rigid body.
The robot is fabricated in Purdue University Technology Center. The biggest challenge is how to get those two materials together. So we have one material for the magnetic head, and we have another material for the helical tail. So the thing is how to connect those two together. We come up with the idea of combining the traditional microfabrication techniques and the nanoscribe 3D printing to get our robot.
We're talking about like tens to 50 microns in dimensions for these objects. It's not like you can take a nut and a bolt and bolt them together, right? So this is very, very small scales, and any kind of impurity or speck of dirt or leftover magnetic particle can, you know, wreak havoc on the laser trying to 3D print. So having to figuring out a way to make these things connect and get these two manufacturing processes to work together was a big key. These robots are designed to swim where there is a fluidic environment in the bodies. This could be in the blood vessels, in the reproductive tract. So we envision not only these be able to swim, but also to do some therapeutic applications. So can we load a drug onto these robots? Can we actually functionalize them for diagnostic capabilities? Add some other functions for a biopsy. So these are some things that we would like to do in the future. So the first step was to get the robots to be able to locomote in this environment and then adapt to this environment to get the best performance, swimming performance. And now once that we're there, now we can think about what can we do while we're there.